हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द साइनेप्स। सो इन द साइनेप्स वी आर गोइंग टू एड्रेस द कॉम्पिटेंसी नंबर 10.2 दैट इज फ्रॉम द सीएनएस फिजियोलॉजी। दैट कॉम्पिटेंसी इंक्लूड द डिस्क्राइब एंड डिस्कस द फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ द साइनेप्स। ओके, द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द साइनेप्स कैन बी आस्क इन द रिटन एग्जामिनेशन और इन वाइवा वॉस। And this topic is integrated with the human anatomy, and the most important concept that we are going to discuss in the synapse, that is the synaptic transmission and properties of the synapse. So in this session we are going to discuss about the basics of the synapse. So here is the outline. First, about the introduction about the synapse: what is synapse, how the term is derived, then we discuss the anatomical classification, that is the structural classification of the synapse, then physiological classification, that include the functional classification of the synapse, and the main important part of this session is a mechanism of the synaptic transmission. Properties of the synapse, that include the in the two parts: one is electrical properties and second is other properties. This property we will discuss in the next session. So first we talk about the history of the synapse. The word synapse from the Greek is synapsis, meaning conjunction, means together or to fasten, and that was given by the Sir Charles Scott Sherrington in 1897, and he has mentioned this term in the Michael Foster's textbook of the physiology. So who discovered the synapse? Sir Charles Scott Sherrington, and he is the man who discovered the synapse. The Sherrington struggled to find the good term that emphasized a union between the two separate elements, and the actual term for synapse was suggested by the English classical scholar Arthur Wooler Verrall. He is also friend of the Michael Foster. So actually, synapse term was suggested by the Arthur Wooler Verrall, but was discovered by the Sir Charles Scott Sherrington. So this is a brief history of the synapse. Now coming to the definition. As you all are aware about the definition of the synapse, and this is the standard definition of the synapse. Synapse is a junction between the two neurons through which impulse passes from the one neuron to the other. So synapse basically the junction of the two neurons. Always remember, in the first neuron there is always axon. Okay, it make the synapse or make the junction with the next neuron. Okay, maybe with the dendrites, maybe with the axons, maybe with the body. Okay, and depending on that we have a different types of the synapse that we will discuss in the anatomical classification. So definition is very simple: synapse is a junction between the two neurons. Look at this, these are the two neurons and this is the junction, axon of the one neurons to the dendrites of the next neurons. Okay, so this is the junction, and this junction is called the junction between the two neurons is called the synapse. The first neuron is called the presynaptic neuron, and the next one is called the postsynaptic neuron. The first neuron, it is a transmitting zone or transmitting neuron, and the second neuron, that is a receiving neuron. So impulse is received by these neurons and impulse is transmitted by first neurons. So this is all about the brief of the synapse. Now the next part of this session is a classification. So there are synapse is classified by the two way. One is anatomical classification based on the structure, and the second is a functional classification of the synapse, that is a physiological classification. Okay, so let's see one by one. This is the standard structure of the neurons. You all are aware about this structure of the neurons. There are three main parts. one is a cell body and this is also called the soma. These are the dendrites which are attached to the soma, and these dendrites are the mostly receptive area, because the most of the time dendrites are the receive the impulse from the first neurons, so that's why it is a receptive zone. And this is the axons, and these are the terminal part of the axon is called the terminal bulb. So basically there are three important parts of the any neurons or typical neurons. One is a dendrite, second is a cell body, and third is a axon. So impulse is coming from this direction and going to in this direction through the axons. So dendrites are the receptive zone. Now we see anatomical classification. As I said earlier, synapse is a junction between the two neurons. Always remember, for the first neuron is always axon. It will make the junction with the next neuron, maybe with the axons, maybe with the dendrites, maybe with the soma. Okay, and based on this, the synapse is a three types. See, for example, axon of the first neuron is junction with the axon of the next neuron. So it is called the exoaxonic. Axon of the first neurons make the junction with the dendrites of the next one, so it is called the exodendritic. And axon of the first neuron make the junction with the soma of the next neuron, that is called the exosomatic. Sometime dendrodendritic is also there. Okay, so in that case junction is formed by the two dendrites, dendrites of the first neuron and dendrites of the second neuron. Okay, but out of this the exodendritic is the most common. Look at the details of the each type. First is the exosomatic, synapse between the axon of the one neurons and cell body of the next neuron. So that is the exosomatic. कहाँ पे present रहेंगे? तो in the motor neurons in the spinal cord and cerebrum and cerebellum. Second is a exodendritic. So here axon and dendrites of the next one. And this is the in the most of the places this type of the synapse are the present. So exodendritic is a most common type of the synapse present in the nervous system. For example, in the motor neurons in the spinal cord, autonomic ganglia, and in cerebellum. Third is a exoaxonic. So synapse between the axon of the one neurons and axon of the other neurons present in the spinal cord. And the last one, and that is very rare, that is a dendrodendritic. Synapse between the dendrites of the one neurons and dendrites of the second neurons. This is very rare, only present in the olfactory bulb. This is concerned with the smell. This is the chemical synapse in which the chemical is released from the first neurons, and this chemical is will act on the next neuron, and based on this transmission will occur. Okay, so such type of the synapse is called the chemical synapse. If the synapse are joined with the gap junction, these are the gap junction. Okay, so one neurons is a make the junction with the next one, and it send the impulse via gap junction, so that is called the electrical synapse. And some synapse are the both have both the properties, chemical bhi release hoga aur gap junction bhi honge, to usko bolenge hum conjoint synapse. Okay, so in physiological classification there are three types. First one is a chemical synapse, second is a electrical synapse, and third one is a conjoint, matlab it is a combination of the both chemical plus electrical. So let's see in the detail. First is the chemical synapse. So most of the synapse are this type. So in anatomical classification, which one is the most common? The most common was the exodendritic. In the physiological classification, which is the most common? Chemical synapse. So here the chemical is released from the first neurons, will act on the second neuron, and transmission will occur. In electrical synapse, here there are the open fluid channels which conduct the electricity from the one cell to another, मतलब one neuron to another neuron, and such synapses are present in the invertebrates and in the smooth and cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle में आपको याद होगा तो there are the gap junction through which the whole conduction is take place, and that is the that you already mentioned in the conducting system of the heart. But yes, invertebrate also only few places in the brain where the electrical synapses are there, or brain में हमारे in the human only three places where the electrical synapses are the present. Okay, that we see in the next slide. Third type is a conjoint synapse. उसमें दोनों चीज़ें साथ में रहेगी, वन इज अ केमिकल एंड सेकंड इज इलेक्ट्रिकल, मतलब केमिकल भी रिलीज होगा. एट द सेम टाइम द इम्पल्स इज ट्रांसमिटेड थ्रू द गैप जंक्शन और थ्रू द फ्लूइड. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द केमिकल साइनेप्स एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल साइनेप्स. ऑब्वियसली इन केमिकल साइनेप्स बिकॉज दिस इज द फंक्शनल क्लासिफिकेशन, तो हाउ द साइनेप्स इज अ फंक्शन, तो वट इज द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ द साइनेप्स, टू पास द इम्पल्स, that is the main function of the synapse. Now the next question is how this impulse is passes. So based on this, the synapse is several types. Chemical, अगर chemical की वजह से होगा तो उसको chemical synapse बोलेंगे. अगर direct electrical signal का transmit हो रहा है through the gap junction तो उसको हम electrical synapse बोलेंगे. अगर दोनों चीज़ें साथ में होगी तो उसको बोलेंगे हम conjoint. Okay? But conjoint is very rare. So mainly discuss only the two, chemical and electrical. So in the chemical synapse, transmission of the signal from the pre to post synaptic site. Here signal from the pre to post or from post to pre. मतलब यहाँ से हम first neuron से second neuron में ही जाएगा impulse in the chemical synapse. But in electrical synapse, 1 to 2 भी होगा और 2 to 1 भी हो सकता है, मतलब in the both the direction. Here the transmission via the neurotransmitter, here via gap junction. So here is only from the pre to post. So chemical synapse is always unidirectional. Is only in the, मतलब impulse is always passes only in the one direction. While in electrical synapse, it is a bidirectional. Here the presence of the synaptic cleft, no cleft is present, but instead of the cleft, low resistance bridge is present and that form the gap junction, which help the passing of the electrical impulse. Here the synaptic delay is a 0.5 millisecond is present. मतलब arrival of the stimulus at the first neuron to the next one, उसमें थोड़ा delay हो जाएगा and that is called the synaptic delay because it is a chemical process. तो कोई भी chemical reaction होगा तो उसमें time लगेगा rather than electrical phenomena. Electrical phenomena is always fast. So synaptic delay is absent in case of the electrical synapse. Chemical synapses are sensitive to the hypoxia, electricals are not. And most of the synapses in the brain are the chemical, so that is the most common type. So CNS mein ya nervous system mein jitne bhi synapse rahenge, most of the are chemical synapses. Or majority. But only three places where the electrical synapses are also present. That you have to remember sometime in MCQ or in the short answer question can be asked. Lateral vestibular nucleus, few places in the cerebral cortex and hippocampus, that is this structure is concerned with the memory. तो ये तीन चीज़ें, तीन places हैं, तीन site हैं जहाँ पे electrical synapse present है in the human brain. Lateral vestibular nucleus, few places in the cerebral cortex and hippocampus. Obviously chemical synapse is a most common, so more in number, and the electrical synapse less in number. So sometime in the examination 2 marks mein ya 4 marks mein kai bar ye compare and contrast mein bhi pucha ja sakta hai, chemical synapse versus electrical synapse. So now this is all about the क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द साइनेप्स. तो हमने दो क्लासिफिकेशन किया, वन इज एनाटॉमिकल बेस्ड ऑन द स्ट्रक्चर एंड सेकंड इज अ फिजियोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन द फंक्शन. एनाटॉमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन में हमारे पास 4 टाइप थे, एक्सोएक्सोनिक, एक्सोडेंड्राइटिक, एक्सोसोमेटिक एंड डेंड्रोडेंड्राइटिक. एक्सोडेंड्राइटिक इज अ मोस्ट कॉमन. इन द फिजियोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन हमारे पास 3 था, number one, that is a chemical synapse, second is a electrical synapse, and third one is a conjoint synapse. Okay, usme se most common tha chemical synapse. So most common is a chemical synapse, so that is by the chemical release. And this, so the chemical is released from the nerve terminal, that is called the neurotransmitter, and that play important role in the synaptic transmission. So that we will discuss in the detail. So first I will take it to you in the brief history of the neurotransmitter. Actually this observation is made by the Otto Loewi, and he was the German pharmacologist. And in 1920s served as a foundation for the concept of the chemical neurotransmission, and his receipt of the Nobel Prize in the physiology and medicine in 1936 for the discovery of the neurotransmitter. Now the acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter, and that was the first discovered neurotransmitter, and was discovered by the Otto Loewi. और उसमें एक बहुत ही interesting चीज़ है by the Otto Loewi. Actually उसको dream में आया था. He is working in the lab, and one night in on the Easter Sunday उसको एक dream आया, और फिर उसने रात को 2 बजे जल्दी जल्दी उठ के फिर वो note down किया. But सुबह होके जैसे सुबह हुई वो क्या लिखा था उसको समझ में नहीं आया और वो सारी चीज़ें भूल गया. लकीली ही गॉट द सेम ड्रीम इन द अगेन इन द नेक्स्ट नाइट. ओके, एंड बाय दिस टाइम ही वेंट टू द लेबोरेटरी इमीजिएटली एट 3 AM एंड कंडक्ट द सिंपल एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑन द फ्रॉग हार्ट. और उसमें उन्होंने क्या किया, ही आइसोलेटेड द हार्ट फ्रॉम द 2 frogs, वन विद द एंड वन विदाउट इट्स इनर्वेशन. उन्हें फ्रॉग को 2 फ्रॉग को डिसेक्ट किया, एक का हार्ट रखा विथ इनर्वेशन मतलब अलॉन्ग विद द नर्व सप्लाई, और दूसरा विदाउट नर्व सप्लाई. बोथ हार्ट वेर अटैच टू द कैन्यूला फील्ड विद द सलाइन सोल्यूशन. द वेगस नर्व ऑफ द फर्स्ट हार्ट वॉज स्टिम्युलेटेड, जो इनर्वेटेड हार्ट था उसका जो वेगस नर्व थी उसको उसने स्टिम्युलेट किया. एंड देन सलाइन सोल्यूशन फ्रॉम दैट हार्ट वॉज ट्रांसफर टू द नॉन इनर्वेटेड हार्ट. ओके, तो वो जो सोल्यूशन जो था हार्ट में वो उसने ट्रांसफर किया इन द नॉन इनर्वेटेड हार्ट में. तो क्या हुआ इन द नॉन इनर्वेटेड हार्ट, द रेट ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रेक्शन स्लोस एज इफ द वेगस नर्व हैज बीन स्टिम्युलेटेड. तो उसका मतलब क्या हुआ, जैसे उन्होंने वेगस नर्व स्टिम्युलेट किया और वो देर इज अ रिलीज ऑफ द केमिकल, एंड दैट केमिकल इज अ एसिटाइलकोलिन, नथिंग बट इज अ एसिटाइलकोलिन. एट दैट टाइम ही सेड इट इज अ वेगो स्टॉप. ओके, बट नाउ इट इज कॉल्ड द एसिटाइलकोलिन, एंड दैट्स वाई द एसिटाइलकोलिन इज अ फर्स्ट डिस्कवर्ड न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर, एंड दैट वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय द ऑटो लुई. सो इट इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी अबाउट द हाउ द न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर इज अ डिस्कवर्ड. ओके, एंड देर आर द 2 types of the neurotransmitter are present. One is a small molecule transmitter, and the second is a large molecule transmitter. The large molecule transmitter is also called the neuropeptide. And examples are the many. Substance P, neurotensin, cholecystokinin, enkephalin. These all are the large molecules transmitters. These are the small molecules, glutamate, GABA, glycine, acetylcholine, dopamine, norepinephrine, epinephrine, and serotonin. And these are the important one. Out of this, some are the excitatory, some are the inhibitory, that we discuss in the synaptic transmission in detail. But here, you just remember the brief idea about the neurotransmitter, and that is the most important are the glutamate and aspartate, and these are the excitatory. Excitatory meaning hota hai yahan pe, once this glutamate and aspartate is released from the axon terminal, that is from the first neurons, it will act on the postsensory membrane of the next neurons, and it will excite the next neuron, and that's why it is excitatory. Agar wo inhibit karega to usko bolenge hum inhibitory. So we have 2 important excitatory neurotransmitter, and these are the glutamate and aspartate. नेक्स्ट वन इज अ गाबा एंड दैट इज अ इनहिबिटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर गामा अमाइनोब्यूटरिक एसिड. सो इन एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर द इम्पल्स इज पासिस फ्रॉम द वन टू द नेक्स्ट वन. हियर इम्पल्स इज अ कट. ओके एंड ग्लाइसिन हैज द बोथ द एक्साइटेटरी एंड इनहिबिटरी इफेक्ट. मतलब ग्लाइसिन इन द फ्यू प्लेसेज इट द एक्ट एज ए एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर एंड इन फ्यू प्लेसेज इट एक्ट एज ए इनहिबिटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर. So that you have to remember. And this is how important neurotransmitter are the synthesized. Glutamate and GABA is from the amino acid alpha ketoglutarate. Acetyl coenzyme and choline form the acetylcholine. Tryptophan form the serotonin. This is also called the 5-hydroxytryptamine. And tyrosine में से derive होगा dopamine, norepinephrine and epinephrine. This norepinephrine is also called the noradrenaline and epinephrine is also called the adrenaline. Now these are the neurotransmitter. It also act as a hormone also. Now the some chemical released by the neurons have little or no direct effect their own but can modify the effect of the neurotransmitter. And these chemicals are the called the neuromodulators. Okay, so what is the neuromodulators which modify the effect of the effect in the nervous system? And we have four important neuromodulators. One is the norepinephrine, second is a serotonin, third is a dopamine, and fourth is a acetylcholine. So that you have to remember. These are the example of the neuromodulators. So now coming to the, so this is all about the neurotransmitter. So you have to remember glutamate and aspartate are the excitatory. GABA is a inhibitory neurotransmitter and glycine have a both the property. And also you have to remember the example of the neuromodulators. Now coming to the second important part of this session, that is a synaptic transmission. Impulse is passed from the one neuron to the next one. So this is the, as we know, you already know the definition of the synapse. There is a junction between the two neurons. मतलब दोनों neuron का कोई एक part participate करेगा in the junction. Always remember जो first neuron रहेगा उसका हमेशा in the most of the case it is always axons और दूसरे का mostly dendrites रहेंगे. Okay, तो जो first जो neuron है उसको बोलेंगे हम transmitting neuron. जो second neuron है उसको बोलेंगे on receiving neuron. मतलब it receive the signal from the first one. That's why. Okay. Now in the first neuron at the axon terminal there is a synaptic vesicle and inside the synaptic vesicle there is a neurotransmitter. And now this neurotransmitter is released in the synaptic cleft. Okay. So ये हो गया free synaptic part. This is the synaptic cleft. That is a space between the presynaptic membrane and postsynaptic membrane, or you can say space between the first and second neuron. And the second, this one is a postsynaptic part of the next neuron. Okay. So, जैसे ही chemical release होगा, that is, ये chemical it is a nothing but is a neurotransmitter. Okay. Now this neurotransmitter or this chemical will act on the it will bind with the receptor that is present on the postsynaptic membrane. Okay, and here on the postsynaptic membrane there is a ligand gated channels are there, ion channels are there. जैसे ये neurotransmitter या chemicals receptor के साथ bind होंगे it will open the ligand gated ion channels और इसके हिसाब से ion की entry होगी या मतलब इनफ्लक्स होगा या इफ्लक्स होगा. ओके, बेस ऑन द विच न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर इज रिलीज. ओके, तो कौन सा रिलीज होगा उसके हिसाब से यहाँ पे चैनल ओपन होगी एंड बेस ऑन द ओपनिंग ऑफ द चैनल देर दिस लीड्स टू द नेट मूवमेंट ऑफ द आयंस फ्रॉम आउटसाइड टू इनसाइड और इनसाइड टू आउटसाइड. इफ द पॉजिटिविटी इज इंक्रीज, इफ द पॉजिटिविटी इज अ इंक्रीज इनसाइड द पोस्ट साइनेप्टिक मेम्ब्रेन it will excite the neurons and it will form the EPSP, that is a excitatory postsynaptic potential. If the inhibitory neurotransmitter are released then it will bind with the receptor, it will open the channels ultimately what happen in the postcentric membrane, the negativity is a increase. जैसे negativity अंदर बढ़ जाएगी in the postcentric membrane, तो क्या होगा, excitability कम हो जाएगी. okay, but ये कब होगा, when the inhibitory neurotransmitter is released. so whenever there is a release of the inhibitory neurotransmitter, the impulse is cut. whenever there is a release of the excitatory neurotransmitter, impulse is a fast. okay, so this is how synaptic transmission occur, that we'll discuss in the detail in the next few slides. look at this, जैसे ही इम्पल्स आएगा यहाँ इन द प्री सैनोटिक न्यूरॉन इन द टर्मिनल बल्ब, ओके, देर इज अ ओपनिंग ऑफ द कैल्शियम चैनल इन द प्री सैनेप्टिक मेम्ब्रेन. जैसे ही कैल्शियम चैनल ओपन होगी, इट विल कॉज द रिलीज ऑफ द कैल्शियम इन साइड द प्री सैनेटिक मेम्ब्रेन एंड दिस लीड्स टू द पुश द वेसिकल टूवर द प्री सैनेटिक मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, और नजीक आएगी. once this synaptic vesicles is a fused with the presynaptic membrane and by the exocytosis the chemical is released and that is called the neurotransmitter. now this chemical it will bind with the receptor present on the postsynaptic membrane. ye jaise receptor bind honge ligand gated ion channel open honge aur uske hisab se ions ki movement hogi and it will leads to the synaptic transmission. okay, so let's see in the detail one by. तो फर्स्ट अराइवल ऑफ द एक्शन पोटेंशियल एट द प्री सैनेप्टिक टर्मिनल, ओपनिंग ऑफ द वोल्टेज गेटेड कैल्शियम चैनल एट द प्री सैनेप्टिक मेम्ब्रेन दैट इज कॉल्ड द एक्टिव जोन, देन एंट्री ऑफ द लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ द कैल्शियम इन टू द प्री सैनेप्टिक टर्मिनल एंड दिस लीड्स टू द फ्री मोबिलिटी ऑफ द वेसिकल्स टूवर्ड द प्री सैनेप्टिक मेम्ब्रेन एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड द रिलीज साइट. नाउ फ्रॉम द वेसिकल्स द केमिकल इज रिलीज बाय द एक्सोसाइटोसिस. नाउ दिस केमिकल इट विल बाइंड विद द रिसेप्टर प्रेजेंट ऑन द पोस्ट साइनेप्टिक मेम्ब्रेन एंड दिस बाइंडिंग कॉज द चेंज इन द आरएमपी ऑफ द पोस्ट साइनेप्टिक मेम्ब्रेन और यू कैन से न्यूरॉन एंड बेस्ड ऑन द आरएमपी चेंज वेदर द न्यूरॉन द नेक्स्ट न्यूरॉन इज एक्साइट और इनिबिट. अगर एक्साइट होगा तो इट विल डेवलप, मतलब उसमें ईपीएसपी डेवलप होगा, दैट इज अ एक्साइटेटरी पोस्ट साइनेप्टिक पोटेंशियल. और अगर इनिबिटरी न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर होगा तो इट विल डेवलप द इनिबिटरी पोस्ट साइनेप्टिक पोटेंशियल. इफ द ईपीएसपी इज मोर देन थ्रेशोल्ड ऑफ द एक्साइटेशन देन एपी इज डेवलप एट द इनिशियल सेवन. सो बेसिकली दिस ईपीएसपी और आईपीएसपी दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द लोकल पोटेंशियल एंड एज यू नो इन द जनरल फिजियोलॉजी लोकल पोटेंशियल वर्सेज एक्शन पोटेंशियल. लोकल पोटेंशियल नेवर प्रोपागेट, एक्शन पोटेंशियल इज ऑलवेज प्रोपागेट. दिस इज द मेन डिफरेंस बिटवीन द लोकल पोटेंशियल एंड एक्शन पोटेंशियल. ईपीएसपी रिसेप्टर पोटेंशियल आईपीएसपी दिस ऑल आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द लोकल पोटेंशियल. बट फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर ईपीएसपी डेवलप हुआ सो लोकल पोटेंशियल डेवलप हुआ तो वंस द लोकल पोटेंशियल इज रीच टू द थ्रेशोल्ड इट विल डेवलप द एक्शन पोटेंशियल. नाउ ऑलवेज रिमेंबर इन एक्सॉन this is the site at where the action potential is developed and that is a initial segment of the axon and that is also called the axon hillock. sometime in mcq such type of the question can be asked. aur ye kyun hoga, because of the in the most of the case it is the opening of the voltage gated sodium channel. so now coming to the electrical properties. तो ये हमने देखा हाउ इम्पल्स इज अ पास. नाउ कमेंट द इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टी, हाउ ईपीएसपी और आईपीएसपी डेवलप होगा. पहले तो कौन सा डेवलप होगा और डेवलप होगा तो कैसे डेवलप होगा, ईपीएसपी एंड आईपीएसपी दैट वी डिस्कस इन द डिटेल. आरएमपी इन द रेस्टिंग कंडीशन इट इज अ माइनस 70. अब ईपीएसपी डेवलप हुआ है तो एक्साइट हुआ तो इट्स कम टू द माइनस 45. सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर in RMP, okay, when we say decrease or increase RMP, increase or decrease RMP, always ignore the minus sign. okay, so from 70 forget about the minus, previous was in the resting condition it was 70, now 45. okay, now it is a 45. okay, so it is a decrease. Once the RMP is a decrease, always it is a excitation. Okay, so always remember D for depolarization. Excitation matlab is toward the depolarization. Okay, so in EPSP, the RMP is a decrease. Why decrease? Because of the movement of the positive ions inside the cell or inside the postsynaptic membrane. Okay, so this is how EPSP is developed. Okay, now once the EPSP reaches to the threshold, it will develop the action potential in the initial segment of the axon, and once the action potential is developed, it will propagate to the next one, and how this impulse is transmitted. तो मे बी कैल्शियम इनफ्लक्स या सोडियम इनफ्लक्स होगा, या तो जो अंदर जो पॉजिटिव आयंस है वो बाहर कम जाएंगे तो भी पॉजिटिविटी बढ़ेगी, ओके, या तो अंदर के जो नेगेटिव आयंस है वो बाहर अंदर कम हो जाएंगे तो भी पॉजिटिविटी बढ़ेगी. सो इन ऑल दिस सिनेरियो ईपीएसपी विल डेवलप. लुक एट दिस. सो द मेन कॉज ऑफ द ओपनिंग इज अ opening of the sodium channel. So sodium influx, in some case it may be because of the decreased chloride influx, matlab negative ion jitne kam rahenge itna positivity badhegi, ya to decreased potassium efflux, matlab potassium andar zyada hota hai inside the cell, okay, to uski movement bahar kam ho gayi to itna potassium andar zyada rahega, more positivity, so RMP will be decrease, okay. And once the RMP is decreased, is toward the excitation or is toward the depolarization. The second cause of the EPSP is increase the number of the excitatory receptor on the postsynaptic membrane. Okay, so EPSP develop hoga. The first condition is a release of the excitatory neurotransmitter. The second condition, increase the positivity inside the postsynaptic membrane by any means. Any means means, maybe because of the sodium influx, maybe because of the decreased chloride influx, or maybe because of the decreased potassium efflux. Okay, ये तीन reason से हो सकता है. Okay, so this is how EPSP. Now IPSP total opposite. In the resting condition में कितना था? -70. यहाँ पे कितना हो गया? -80. Just ignore the minus sign. 70 to 80 हुआ. RMP is increase मतलब decrease excitability, means toward the hyper repolarization. Okay, and hyper repolarization matlab IPSP develop hua hai. Okay, the reason are ya to chloride ion ki movement zyada hui ya potassium jo andar tha wo bahar nikal gaya. So in both the cases negativity will increase inside the postsynaptic membrane, and once the negativity is increase, it always leads to the IPSP, that is a inhibitory postsynaptic potential. Inhibitory matlab impulse is cut, no further transmission of the impulse will take place if the IPSP is developed. So it is the total opposite to the EPSP. So the main cause of the opening is the opening of the voltage gated calcium channel, sorry, chloride channel, and this leads to chloride influx into the postsynaptic membrane, okay, or increase the potassium influx efflux, or decrease the number of the excitatory receptor on the postsynaptic membrane. So these are the reasons for the IPSP. So IPSP ke liye first condition is a release of the inhibitory neurotransmitter, example are the GABA, and second condition, increase the negativity in the postsynaptic membrane. Wo kaise negativity badhegi? Either by the chloride influx or increased potassium efflux. And this is the difference between the EPSP versus IPSP. So in EPSP always there is a excitatory neurotransmitter, glutamate and aspartate. In IPSP, GABA and glycine. Here the neurotransmitter is bind to the postsynaptic membrane. यहाँ पे भी bind होगे, but यहाँ पे ऐसी channel open होगी, या तो ऐसा net movement of the ions होगा कि जिसकी वजह से ultimately in the net result the positivity inside the postsynaptic membrane will increase. So this leads to the EPSP. यहाँ पे भी चैनल्स ओपन होंगी, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द ओपनिंग ऑफ द चैनल्स, उसकी वजह से क्या होगा? देर इज अ इंक्रीज द नेगेटिविटी इनसाइड द पोस्टसिनैप्टिक मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, सो यहाँ पे न्यूरॉन की एक्साइटेबिलिटी कम हो जाएगी, यहाँ पे न्यूरॉन्स की एक्साइटेबिलिटी बढ़ जाएगी. ओके, बढ़ जाएगी मतलब टूवर्ड द डिपोलराइजेशन, कम हो जाएगी मतलब टूवर्ड द रिपोलराइजेशन। तो यहाँ पे इम्पल्स कट होंगे, यहाँ पे इम्पल्स पास होंगे, ओके। एंड इफ पी एस पी इज मोर देन द थ्रेशोल्ड ऑब्वियसली इट लीड्स टू द डेवलप द एक्शन पोटेंशियल इन द इनिशियल सेगमेंट ऑफ द एक्सॉन्स एंड इट इज फर्दर प्रोपागेटेड एंड दिस इज हाउ इम्पल्स इज अ पास और ट्रांसमिटेड, ओके। सो फॉर द इम्पल्स ट्रांसमिशन ई पी एस पी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, टू कट द इम्पल्स आई पी एस पी इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ओके। इन द नर्वस सिस्टम दोनों चीज़ें हमारे लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है, न्यूरॉन्स को एक्साइट करना भी इंपॉर्टेंट है और उतना ही इंपॉर्टेंट है आई पी एस पी, ओके। बिकॉज फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन अगर हम सिंपल एग्जाम्पल लें, हमें अगर अवेक रहना है तो इट मस्ट बी ई पी एस पी, ओके। तो कई न्यूरॉन्स में हमारा ई पी एस पी चलना चाहिए, अगर हमको सो जाना है तो आई पी एस पी विल बी डोमिनेंट, ओके। सो दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स। सो इन द लिविंग कंडीशन और इन लिविंग लाइफ, ओके, इन बायोलॉजी बोथ आर इम्पोर्टेंट, ई पी एस पी एंड आई पी एस पी। नाउ अदर प्रॉपर्टीज दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द टूडेज सेशन, उसमें हमने ब्रीफ अबाउट द साइनेप्स एंड उसके बाद हमने किया अबाउट द ब्रीफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ द साइनेप्स, हु डिस्कवर्ड, सो सर स्कॉट वेरिंगटन, ओके। देन उसका हमने क्लासिफिकेशन किया, एनाटॉमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन, फिजियोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन, द ब्रीफ अबाउट द न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर, एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर, इनहिबिटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमिशन, मेकेनिज्म फॉर द साइनेप्टिक ट्रांसमिशन एंड ई पी एस पी एंड आई पी एस पी, हाउ दे डेवलप एंड हाउ द इम्पल्स इज अ पास फ्रॉम द वन साइनेप्स मतलब वन न्यूरोन टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूरोन। सो बेसिकली द साइनेप्स इज अ जंक्शन बिटवीन द टू न्यूरोन्स एंड द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ द न्यूरोन्स इज टू पास द इम्पल्स और फॉर द इम्पल्स ट्रांसमिशन, ओके। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द टुडे सेशन। सो इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द साइनेप्स। Okay, thank you.